Hey boy, pay attention. Today's lesson comes from Richard III. It's basically like a novella where the little brother is mad at the bigger brother because he's successful. Now is the winter of our discontent, made glorious summer by the son of York, and all the clouds that lowered upon our house, in the deep bosom of the ocean buried. Now are our brows bound with victorious wreaths, our bruised arms hung up for monuments, our stern alarms changed to merry meetings, our dreadful marshes to delightful measures. Grim-visaged war hath smoothed his wrinkled front, and now, instead of mounting barbed steeds to fight the souls of fearful adversaries, he capers nimbly in a lady's chamber to the lascivious pleasing of a lute. But I, that am not chafed for sportive tricks, nor made to court an amorous looking-glass, I that am rudely stamped and want love's majesty to strut before a wanton ambling nymph, I that am curtailed of this fair proportion, sheeted a fissure by dissembling nature, deformed, unfinished, sent before my time into this breathing world scarce half made up, and that so lamely and unfashionable that dogs bark at me as I halt by them. Why, I in this weak piping time of peace have no delight to pass away the time, unless to spy my chattel in the sun, and descant on my known deformity. And therefore, since I cannot prove a lover to entertain all these fair well-spoken days, I am determined to prove a villain and hate the idle pleasures of these days. Plots have I laid, inductions dangerous, by drunken prophecies, libels, and dreams to set my brother Clarence and the king in a deadly hate, the one against the other. And if King Edward be as true and just as I am subtle, false, and treacherous, this day should Clarence closely be mewed up about a prophecy which says that G of Edward's heirs, the murderer, shall be. So what he's saying is he's deformed and his brother's off doing you know what, and he's mad and can't pass the time, so he's going to turn his two brothers against each other.